It's my pleasure, and it's even my honor to be a part of MES, one of the webinar series. First of all, let me thank Mansoor Ali sir and my friend Amil and Sachin for getting me to this platform. Definitely, it's always good to be in touch with the young aspirants who are going to be our future citizens of the country. And definitely, as Mansoor sir said, that introduction was quite interesting, and it covered almost all the contexts and the problems that we are facing today. By the time I was thinking about MES, anyway, since I'm coming from Malappuram district, you know, my connection with MES is not, you know, new as today. I'm very much, you know, in connection with all the MES institutes back in Malappuram district, and of course, MES institutes, establishments and their community activities, like now it's widespread across Kerala and even beyond Kerala borders. So I thank the MES group also for giving me this chance. So I hope it's very audible. Amil sir.
Yes sir.
Okay. So I don't know the variety or the complexity of the crowd. Still, I have an idea about them, like what Sachin said. It's a group of students and a few people who are working professionals, and that too from different sectors. So I don't know how I can accommodate the expectations and requirements of all these people. But still, I'll go through some of the glimpses of the industry, and later if you have any questions from the specific sector or personal you know, problems related to that industry, you can ask me, no issues. As per my humble knowledge, I can try to help you. So let's start with the prospects and challenges during and after COVID-19. We were expecting the after COVID-19 scenario very soon, but as per WHO and other governments all over the world, including the you know, strongest economies like America, it is taking much more time than expected. Only yesterday's case we can take. See, yesterday itself, 75,000 new patients are reported in United States of America. And 1.4 lakhs of people, they died as of now. The, you know, one of the strongest medical, you know, equipment manufacturer and exporter of the world, United States, they are actually not breathing properly. That's the situation. And even our own God's own country, Kerala, the situation is alarming. Yeah, I'm seeing the news. It's around 700 plus now. And that too, the majority, the chunk is coming from now community spread. And yesterday government declared the community spread aspect. So we are in actually a very difficult situation. I'm very sorry to remind you this, because we need to take an action. Unless and until we know the situation, we don't take an action. And we are the people who can even influence and support others, elders in the community, when this kind of new situation is coming. When new technologies and new problems are coming, of course, younger generation will have a better access and knowledge to such things. So we are the right people to motivate and support our elders and other people in the family, definitely. So Indian job market, when we see, of course, the implications of the COVID, right now we can consider only that. Because of that, Indian job market is completely down, we can say. It's not only Indian job market, around the world. As Mansoor Ali sir was talking, there is a reverse migration also happening. See, the medical facilities, the support from the government, and you know, other infrastructural support, everything is very good in even Gulf, GCC countries, and all other European continents. But still, people are coming back. Why? There comes the question, why? Job. My friends, job is the problem. If we have job over here and a consistent income, people would continue, definitely. But each and every drop of water we drink here, we need to pay. So without a job, it's very difficult to survive out of our country. Yeah, so that is the main problem. So this problem is prevalent all over the world. It's not only in India. In India, when you take, of course, our problem is in India, definitely. The Center for Monitoring Indian Economy, CMIE, their latest report says that during the last 4 months, 25% of employees from the organized private sector of India, they either lost their job or they faced a major salary cut, and expected it's 30% above very soon. So that is the current situation in India. So one person in every 4 person working in the private sector, they are losing their job or they have a threat to their job. So imagine the size of the population in India and the number of people. They are going to affect the economy in that way. You might be heard about placements. Of course, when you are in the final year, companies are coming to colleges for placing us. Yeah, and our colleges are also doing very good in that. But you see today's situation. Now, companies are not looking for campuses for placements. I mean, they are going for a concept called outplacement. Outplacement is nothing but when they are sending their employees out, when they are reducing the cost, cutting the number of employees, they have to place them somewhere. Good companies, they do that. I mean, so good companies, good MNCs, they are outplacing their employees. They are giving a time, 3 months to 6 months, to their employees for finding a new job. And Naukri, one of the biggest job portals in India, they started a new platform called Outplacement Platform, where MNCs or companies, they can register their employees' names and details and experience and help them to get some part-time, temporary, or any kind of jobs which can support them for the time being. That's the situation today. It's very alarming. But we cannot hide all these things. We have to know the reality, definitely. Because we can go ahead only by stepping into the reality, and very less or no recruitment in the service sector of India. See, from 2015, Indian GDP is mainly depending on the tertiary sector, that service sector, more than 50%. Less than 50% is only coming from agricultural sector, though that is the backbone of the country. So tertiary sector, it is mainly depending on travel, tourism, hospitality, and all these kind of services. These things are completely stopped. So imagine the job loss. Yeah. Pilots, they do not have any job. Have you ever heard that a pilot, you know, who come out, pilots, they, you know, get their placements before they complete their studies. You know, that most demanded job in the world, pilots. I'm seeing in some of my LinkedIn pages, pilots are looking for opportunities. That's the situation. And job offers, you know, of course, the companies in India, first they try to get placements from, you might be knowing, IIMs and IITs. And already the job offers, which are made by many companies in IIMs and IITs, revoked. And it's continued to be revoked. They are going to, you know, extend actually the joining date. Very recently, one of my, relatives, she got, she's an electronics engineer. She got a job in one of the companies in Chennai. And she was supposed to join last month. And even her date of joining, it's postponed to, October, November time. And even that time, it's not sure. So that's the current scenario that let's understand, but still there are some prospects, I can tell you. Yeah. So, but before going to the prospects, let me tell you the challenges or the reasons why, our economy is shrinking. As we all know, the first reason is COVID-19 and the graph is increasing. We are not able to control it. Yeah. Though, the most literated state of India, Kerala. Even Kerala community spread is reported. I'm not going to the reasons or the explanations or, all those things, but still, you know, the fact is that the number is increasing. So everything is uncertain. Yeah. So nobody is ready to invest anywhere. Yeah. Even the richest people or the richest organizations, they are not going to make any more new investments in their factory, in their marketing, in their advertising. They just keep the pace. That's all. And even that, they are reducing. Yeah. And there are no recruitments. So, of course, why should they recruit? So that is the first reason. And second comes consumer demand. You see, when you take our situation in UAE, okay, most of the Fridays and Saturdays, only people were going out and spending whatever they earn, you know, a week that would be spent in that weekend. That's the way, you know, outing, you know, then all kind of leisure time, family, the luxuries they are spending in houseboats and all these things. Everything is restricted. No luxury, no consumption. My friend was running a desert safari, you know, business in Dubai. And, you know, his income was unlimited, actually. You know, we all have a limited salary. But this guy's income, he doesn't know how much it's coming per day or per week. It's depending on the number of tourists coming. And he is having 2-3 Land Cruisers. Now he is not able to put petrol in those Land Cruisers because no customers. Where is desert safari now? Only desert is there. No safari at all. So that's the situation. Consumer demand is dropped like anything for all unnecessary. We call it as unnecessary or luxury. But before it was not luxury. Even all of us from Kerala also, we used to go out for dinner. Yeah, every weekend. Not every weekend, every weekdays. So all those situations are changing. So luxury spending, yeah, in tourism, travel, all other hospitality sectors, it's reduced. So, of course, jobs are affected directly and a lot of indirect jobs also. So these two reasons we can think. And unemployment among the educated is very high, especially in Kerala. When we take Kerala, one of the most literated states, most of the people have education. Yeah, they all are 10 pass, plus 2 degree. Many postgraduates are there, but still, you take people and conduct a survey, the number of people getting jobs, especially in their field, is very less. So, another way we can say, right skilled labor is also not accessible or available in India. We can see a lot of engineers. Yeah, I know personally a lot of people. Lot of engineering students, they work in the banking sector. And even inside engineering, a person taking mechanical will go for another sector, and automobile will go for electronics. Electronics would go for, you know, it's like that. And it's not only in engineering field, my friends. Yeah. Before COVID, even nurses were working in marketing field, you know that. But now at least, some of the sectors like pharmaceuticals, nurses, doctors, all these people have their jobs. COVID has safeguarded their jobs, or they demanded in their particular industries because of COVID at least. Otherwise, in India, this was another situation. Why it's happening? It's happening because of no proper career counseling, first thing. And second thing is salary. People, though we have done, you know, engineering or, there are a lot of doctors, they do businesses in India, Kerala. Yeah. Then why did they go for this 5 years degree? A very noble degree. And they are supposed to serve the society. I mean, they could do their business, but they did not have done this. Yeah. So actually, you are wasting your time and another person's opportunity. So, maybe the reasons could be, I told you, the salary is one thing. Whatever the degree we have taken, still, when we get a better salary, we are ready to compromise on our area or our core values. And stability, another thing. Why many people are moving to banking sector, though it's not at all related to engineering? There are a few people, they are in the background support. That's fine. But many people who are working in marketing, accounts, you know, all other sections, finance, HR, it's all because of the consistency or safety. Yeah, so they're sure that they get a consistent income. Yeah, and a better salary. So these are the problems. Definitely, we need to address these problems in the long run. We had a great visionary person. We all might know, but we miss him today. That's our former president, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. He used to travel around the country, yeah, and go to each and every small educational institutions, government, private, and you know, IIMs, IITs, all. And he used to motivate the young generation by solving their doubts. And he had a great vision also. So such people are also missing in our country who can guide our young generation, yeah, to get placed rightly. Let's go to the prospects anyway. Yeah, we should not only think about negative. Yeah, when we think about especially APJ Abdul Kalam, yeah, he has spread maximum positivity. Even in the negative scenarios and negative time, he is the one, he has urged, you know, Indian people and the, you know, especially the student community to come up and support the country and the families. When we see the prospects, the positive things, see, I told you the pandemic is widespread across the world and the problems are also for everyone. Yeah, even Americans, Indians, they're facing the same problem. Hello, someone's mic. Hello. Yeah, thank you. The encouraging news is, out of 44 countries, I mean, worst affected countries due to COVID, a study was conducted recently. And among these 44 countries, I mean, the main 44 countries around the world, 4 countries only showed that still there is a positive hiring trend. In the sense, still there is recruitment happening, you know, than the people who are leaving. You get it? So among those 4, India comes. So only 4 countries in the world, they are still having a positive hiring trend. It means recruitments are still happening in some of the sectors. First is Japan only. Second is Taiwan. And we know Japan and Taiwan, how they manage their COVID crisis also. And third is China. Okay, they are coming back slowly. And fourth is India. And all other countries, they have a negative trend in the sense there is less or no recruitment. See, today, Indian market, Indian job market is slowly, vibrating, you know, with an intake in the field of, e-commerce, not just commerce, electronic commerce, then IT services sectors like BPOs, KPOs. If you have any friends or your cousins or seniors working in BPO, KPO sectors, you can ask them. Their job is somewhat stable, right? Then pharmaceuticals, telecom also. Telecom is also seeing a revival. Yeah, communication and pharmaceutical sectors also. So, see, I've seen the department instrumentation and automation. These are engineers, definitely. Now you have to think in a different perspective. Yeah, see, it's all about businesses. Which all the businesses growing in the country or which all the industries growing in the country? That way you have to think. Yeah, whether you are automation or civil or engineers or you are coming from BBA, BCom or BCA, MCA or any other stream. Okay, you have your core skills, whatever the courses or the disciplines you have studied. Definitely, based on that, you can do some more certification programs or some value-added courses. You get it? That can place you somewhere, easily. Because only with BCA or that engineering degree you apply, sometimes you don't get into a particular, job or a company. Now onwards, before completing your studies, you have to start looking for the job requirements in various industries. You can see the job requirements. They will mention, these are the skills we are expecting. These are the certifications we are preferring. And this is what the experience we are looking for. Yeah, so even the experience you can add as your internship and you know your projects. Nowadays your projects are and internships are considered as experience only. So choose your intern company, your project also very wisely. I know the quality of the education was also one of the questions for foreign companies to come to India and recruit people, because when they see the project of one university, sometimes they could see the same project in another university. Many times students are copying projects, and many times even, you know, the universities are like leaving it. So these things should be changed. I'm just speaking openly. It's our country, it's our university, it's our you know, students. So never start doing anything which is already done by someone else. When you choose your project, when you're choosing your internship companies, see what exactly you want to do in future or which kind of job you are looking for. Based on that, you have to choose and put your effort. If you put more effort now, future, you will effortlessly get your job and you continue in that sector, I'm sure. And right now, whoever is, you know, whoever has passed out or passing out, we have a lot of opportunities now in machine learning, artificial intelligence related jobs. Then, of course, mobile related, Android and iOS technology. See, if you are engineers from electronics or, you know, any other fields, yeah, basically engineers, of course, you will be thorough about most of the technological and technical aspects. But you need to see which part of industry is booming. Right now, I said mobile sector, especially the hardware sector. Yeah. So it's still increasing. You see, many companies are going to come to India now. Google is also coming to India. You might have heard about that agreement with our Prime Minister, Sundar Pichai, has done. Apple is bringing their production facilities to India from China. See, most of the countries are now angry with China. So that is one way good for us. But if they won't simply come to us, and even if they come, they will first analyze and monitor how things are happening here. If it is not good, they will even go to Africa, where employees are cheap, where employment is cheaper. So we need to get this Apple and Google with us. Like this, bigger companies can always transform our economies very strongly. And of course, so one more thing I want to tell you is machine learning, artificial intelligence only. This area also, it's booming. Yeah. The point was, yeah, what is the costliest asset for any company today, you know? For any company, the costliest thing today, many answers would be there. Their financial assets, their investments, their patents, brand value. No, everything's changed. Today, the most important asset of any company is data, information. So information is the key. Now, see, if you have information, that to correct access to correct information, you can plan accordingly and you can reach your customers and you can be successful. Now, information is sold actually from companies to companies. Everybody is looking for information. So be safe with your Facebook and LinkedIn profiles. Even your information could be stolen. Yeah, many of the issues are happening in Kerala and India based on the information discussions only. Anyways, because information is very, very important today. So there are a lot of job opportunities in data related jobs also. Data scientists, data analytics. I mean, even the data analytics could be in marketing, marketing analyst, financial analyst. So you need to see, I mean, you need to do some certifications in analysis courses. You might be doing some projects. Of course, you'll be applying some softwares like Excel, SPSS, MinTab, and many other things, right? For collecting the data, recording the data, processing the data, and come to some conclusions that will help your final findings. I mean, help to make conclusions, right? So you need to learn more on these analysis tools. If you have very good analysis power and knowledge on such softwares, your job is guaranteed today. Yeah, so these professionals are on high demand today, I can say. So when we think about the future job skills, one recent survey conducted by World Economic Forum, what they say is 35% of the job skills that we are using today will not be required after 2025. So after 5 years, many of the skills which we are developing today in our classrooms, in our universities, and even in our companies by going for different courses and all, would not be required. It will be all replaced with new skills, or machines will be doing that. Already we know, we don't require many skills today. We don't need to memorize anything today. You agree? Do you remember any one of your family members' phone number? At least please, you should have your wife's number or your dad's number, okay? So maybe we remember one or two numbers today. We don't require memory because devices have replaced that. We don't require that skill anymore. Even in a company, we don't need to remember everything. Yeah. Your mobile calendar will be, if it's iOS or Android, your mobile calendar, once it's set with the whole organizational calendar, morning, once you enter the office, you get notifications. Sir, meeting this time. Sir, this is the birthday of this person. Yeah. And all, things will come to you. You don't need to memorize. That skill is not required today. You don't need to calculate also today. Yeah. Before we used to calculate, when we were studying, we used to learn with 1, 2, 3 fingers. Then we used to calculate big numbers before. But today, even I cannot calculate simple numbers because we have calculators. Have you seen any offices? Even calculators are not used today. Everything is softwares only. You enter the number, all calculations are done. And our decision-making skill, another skill, is also 50% is reduced now. When you go for a drive, for example, from Cochin to Trivandrum, who is guiding you? GPS is guiding you. When one of the routes is blocked, GPS will show you another route. So your decision making is also very easy. You just need to finally touch one of the ways. So still you have a role today, right? But future, even that role is going to be vanished. It will driverless cars are going to come from Google. Yeah, in Dubai, there are flying cars coming very soon. So once you enter the car, there's no driver. You set the destination. That's it. It will take you to the destination. Yeah, on the road or through air. On the way, if there is any traffic on the road, you cannot change the route. It knows where to change, how to change. It will deviate and it will take you to the destination anyway. That's it. So, and many experts say that very soon, in most of the board meetings, you might have seen board meetings happening in MNCs and corporations and all, where MNCs and multinational companies, corporations, board meetings happening, very soon there should be members, they are called robots. Robots would be sitting and giving suggestions related to marketing, budgeting, investment plans, and all these things with artificial intelligence. And we need to consider their suggestions also. Yeah. So these are the things going to come very soon in the future. So technology is going to invade our life like anything than we have expected. Many things we expect that could happen in 2030, 40, 50, all are happening or going to happen very soon. Maybe 10, 15 years are going to be skipped in the evolution of human history. So, in future, if we are equipping ourselves, or when teachers, we are equipping our students for the future, definitely we should educate them on technological literacy. It's not just the literacy. A few years back, it was computer literacy, we used to say. Yeah, only literacy is not enough, my friends. You should know Microsoft Office and some operating systems and all, correct? And how to draft a mail, at least you should have a mail ID. Gone. Now, again, I remember Mansoor Ali sir's point, third industrial revolution, was one of the reasons to change the human evolutions and inventions. But today, Today, we are in the fourth industrial revolution, my friends, and it is called technological revolution. So we are in the technological revolution now, where we need to have technological literacy. It's not only BCA you are studying. It's not just BBA you are studying. You need to bring technology into that, applications of technology. Yeah, you're not simply calculating your data. Even in your project, you're using a lot of technology, and we are actually far behind in that. Many countries, you know, they are developed, already have gone different steps ahead. We also need to do that. So first is technological literacy. That is the key skill or the key, you know, trait which is expected by employers in future. And second is your flexibility and adaptability with the changing situations. See, every industry is changing quicker than we have expected. See, banking industry, ATMs came, yeah, then online banking came. You know, many employees in India, when online banking came and the banks were moving to online, they resigned their jobs because they were not able to cope up with the, you know, technological evolution. See, now it's a game changing. Without going to a bank, you can open an account today. You can move your funds today. You can close your account today. So that's the way. So that's the way the bank employees are also to be you know, trained and develop their skills. So you need to be very adaptive and flexible, and you should be able to work in different departments of an organization where you are joining. That also will be considered as an extra skill. Yeah. And when we're talking about robots, artificial intelligence, everything, one of the skills which still robots cannot replace humans, that is the most important skill, you know, which most of the companies would be expecting from people, you know, when they are recruiting in future. That is nothing but creativity or innovation, we can call it. Because even these robots are nothing but the creations of human, right? So creativity and innovation, it's nothing but bringing new practices, new methods, and new ideas to even the existing things. Yeah, when you market your product, when you, you know, make a new product or a service, when you design something, what kind of new elements you can add, what kind of extra features you can add that is not existing. That's an ability or a skill which is expected from employees. Yeah, so companies would look for accountants with creativity, marketing people with creativity, and creativity cannot be learned by going for a course and all. Like, we go for a lot of personality development courses and we build our personalities and all, right? And communication courses we go for. See, but creativity and innovation cannot be developed in that way. That we have to, you know, whatever we do in our life, even if it is simple things, try to do it in a different way. Yeah, that reduce the effort and that adds more value. You get it? Anything. You can see a lot of innovations and creativities that we are using today. Yeah. So this is what I want to tell you. I hope I've taken enough time. And again, with APJ Abdul Kalam sir's quote, I would like to conclude this session. I don't know whether you have heard about this great quote of APJ Abdul Kalam. All birds find shelter during rain, but eagle avoids rain by flying above the clouds. So what he tries to say is problems are common. Problems are common to all of us, but attitude makes the difference. So he wants us to change our attitude according to the changing scenario and the problem. Then only we can come up. That's what he is telling. So the concept of education has transformed from school certificates and mere university degrees to lifelong learning, we can call. See, most of the successful people we are seeing today, yeah, in business field or political or any other field, are not with MBAs or, you know, M-Techs and all, or doctorates and all. It's all through their lifelong learning. So we also need to put effort for learning from the life. And today we have a lot of online courses available, freely available. So you need to now widen your scope, increase your scope. Yeah. And today I told you those three key skills, and you know, and youngsters also should spend more time for, you know, constantly upgrading your skills, knowledge and abilities in your area. Yeah. And more than spending time for your social media network, or you know, building your network in social media like FB, you can strengthen, instead you can strengthen your professional network like LinkedIn. Yeah, so that also will help us to get connected with companies. Nowadays you get a lot of job openings through LinkedIn only. Yeah, Facebook we get only likes and comments, but LinkedIn you get a lot of job opportunities. So you need to strengthen your professional network. Yeah, so don't take offended. Yeah, I'm just telling a joke only. So of course our social media networks are important, everything is important, but need of the hour, as your sir was telling, need of the hour. So what is the need of the hour today? Give priority to that and give more focus for your professional networking, and go ahead. Also collect information related to your career, such things. Yeah. While concluding, I would like to say one more thing. Yeah, I have recently started you know, a channel for my students when it you know, when we started online teaching. Yeah, I couldn't go to my final year students and give sessions, yeah, related to their placement and all. So so it was only started for my students initially, that you can also watch if you have time. Yeah, it's learning plus career. It's only for students and learners. Yeah, that's it. Thank you.